well-armed enemy force. They've got an entire army down here.
A few minutes to chat.
Do I have a choice?
Lambert needs to talk to you.
You know I hate that.
Sam?
What's the situation, Lambert?
We've lost contact with Agents Madison and Blaustein. You need to go bring them back.
And my daughter?
We'll take care of her.
Greetings, fellow Woodlings. Welcome back to some more Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell. This is actually be my last video. I'm playing this after I've completed the game here. And this video right here will be featuring an alternative universe where Sam exists. They actually made a completely different version for the PlayStation 2, the Chinese that is. I think it was made in Shanghai, Ubisoft Shanghai. And yeah, they basically just made a completely different game. Not a completely different game, it was, it had very close resemblance to the original Splinter Cell, but they basically took a few artistic liberties here and there, and that's basically what I want to see through this playthrough. For you guys, it'll only be level 6, that would be, you know, or maybe 5.5, which would be nuclear power plant, which is a level which is not available elsewhere. So yeah, I'll show you guys the intro for the PS2 version, a few cinematics here and there which I find cool, and then we'll head right into it and see what happens in the mission. This game thus far, I've already seen the intro and it actually seems more Pandora Tomorrow-ish in its cutscenes. It seems more action-packed than infiltration spy thriller sort of a game, but let's see how the game differs. The cinematics are certainly different, over-the-top PS2 sort of action, but I guess that's just what the PS2 was meant to do. I'm not playing this on my PlayStation 2, I'm actually playing this on PCSX2, so I don't really know how the performance is going to be, but let's see. Anyway, on to the video now. Now before we get on to the actual Duke Power Plant level, I just wanted to show you the differences between the endings of Kalinatek between the PS2 version and the PC version. As you can see, Wilkes just isn't here in the PC version, and the fact that I suck at using the controller, I can barely aim, and I'm all out of medkits, obviously. So yeah, at least I've got some shadows here and I can approach the situation tactically within the confines of this game. I'm still trying to, I still haven't figured it out that I need to get over into the thing up there, into the Osprey, to actually extract. I'm thinking, okay, maybe once I kill all the bad guys, I'll be able to extract. But that is unfortunately not the case. Anyway, the shadow helped me out there. And yeah, the level design in this game is quite different. To clear the obvious, this is a post-gameplay commentary recording, obviously. But as you can probably tell, I mean, you should be able to tell by now. So that's it. This is pretty much how the ending goes for this level. You just need to climb upon this box and jump into the Osprey for extraction. And that's it.
What's that you're reading?
Flash notes on the U.S. soldiers. How's that connection coming?
I don't think Sarah's home.
Fisher. Lambert.
You're going to be signal hunting the next couple of missions. We traced the data stream as far as a nuclear power plant called Nadezhda. We lose it there.
Encryption?
Partly, but it has more to do with the nature of Nikoladze's network. It's been cobbled together from microwave relays, local lines, line of sight stuff.
Anything they could find. I'll come back with more details once you're on the ground.
What do you got for me?
No answer, man. Here, you can leave a message.
Hi, we can't come to the phone right now, so please leave a message. Thanks.
Sarah? Sarah, if you're there, pick up. This is Fisher. I mean Dad. I'm just checking up on you. I'm sure you're fine. It was real good to see you. You can leave me a message at my office when you get this. Just let me know you're doing all right. Bye.
Revealed moments ago caught U.S. intelligence completely by surprise. The video webcast by their Georgian captors shows the soldiers mistreated but in apparent good health. The Army has not yet released the identity. President David Bowers personally thanked agents of the FBI for their patriotic heroism in the Halloween night apprehension of three Georgian mercenaries from the Kalinatek building in downtown Langley. All three Georgian mercenaries have been identified as current employees of the Russian Secret Service. NATO inspectors and U.S. intelligence have begun focusing their search for Combined Nikoladze on Russia and its satellites. Though the Kremlin has denied any involvement, diplomatic relations have become... NATO inspectors are meeting light resistance in their investigation into Russia's possible support of Combined Nikoladze's campaign of terror against the United States. Diplomatic channels remain open, but grow more strained with each has called the Georgian information crisis a high-tech Vietnam, citing the enormous cost, ambiguous cause, and bewildering loss of said that Russia must cooperate more fully with NATO inspectors if they wish to avoid an escalation to hostility.
What is the Kremlin trying to hide?
Nadezhda Nuclear Plant, Kola Peninsula, Russia, November 6th, 2004, 1950 hours. Trace the microwave relay. Data retrieved from Kalinatek reveals that Nikoladze uses an unconventional network of relays to communicate with Georgian terrorist cells. Background electronic noise surrounding the Nadezhda nuclear power plant in northern Russia makes it impossible to trace the network beyond this point.
All right, Fisher, we're hunting an antenna. We're going to have to cut down on the background noise before we'll be able to pull the electronic intel out of the room. Hence the meltdown alert. Details on your offset.
Alright, so this first section of the game is pretty, buggy, so to speak. There's a guy down there, and one of the better ways to distract him is to shoot the camera out, take, like, take two birds out with one swoom, and yeah. And now, depending upon what this guy does, he does like a few things here and there. Sometimes he would get out, like, you know, just stop and admire the camera. In that case, you should not rush over to this window here. By the way, this game, this level at least, isn't that well optimized, so actually jumping through the window like that is one difficult task. Here you just want to stick into this shadow right here. You can't see the shadow, but there's like barely enough of a shadow to where this guy can't see you, and just stick right there. I'm just being safe here because of the lack of quick saves in the console version, which is actually frankly shocking to me. But anyway, I'm just trying to play it a little safe and just sticking around here, waiting to see whether he comes back or not, because as far as I remember, if I remember correctly, I think I spent around close to 40 minutes or so just trying to get through this one section alone, and that just tells you how difficult this one section is. But yeah, it's riddled with bugs. Some things don't work like they're supposed to, and the enemy groupings are super tight. I think it was made for you to knock people out and proceed. At least that's what the first game was intended to do. Anyway, he is stopping in front of the window admiring it right now for some reason. We don't know why. Maybe he just wants the warmth inside the room. But anyway, once he's gone, you can stick to the wall and keep continuing on to your destination. Stick to the wall, get to the huge silo things. I don't know what they are. Refineries? There's something. But yeah, just stick to the stay near these capsules, and when this guy makes another pass back over to his, you know, usual patrol route, then stick to the left side of the map and just keep going. And so here's the first bug that we have here. You see that guy over there? He's not supposed to notice us. We are in the darkness. At most, he should be suspicious that maybe he saw someone. But yeah, he has got no reason to notice us, but he does anyway. And as a result, we're just going to have to, you know, just sit here and wait for some time while this guy gets back into his normal patrol routine. Yeah, let him just walk around and get back into his patrol routine. We'll also be waiting for that guy in the distance, the one we just passed on our way here, to, you know, get back onto his own patrol so that we can safely sneak into the room where we want to go. So yeah, in case you guys skip through the Kalinatek section, this is a post gameplay recording, as you guys can probably tell. More like a post gameplay commentary recording, as you guys can probably tell. I had to try this level so many times, and since I was so not used to playing on the controller, I thought, you know what, let me just shut the fuck up for the time being just try to focus on the game instead, because this first section, right up until the first checkpoint, it does require a ton of focus from you, because it just seems like the game just wants to sort of force you into a firefight there. Again, I stopped here because the other guy is looking right at us, and now he turned back and we are clear to proceed. And yet, as you can see, I'm not entirely used to the controller yet, so I'm still having difficulty in moving Sam right now. And I think I'm yet to properly configure my controller to the point that, you know, I can safely clear the dead zone with every single move of the analog stick. Or maybe it's just my lack of practice, or maybe it's both, who knows. So here, this guy suffers from yet another bug. The problem with this guy is, if I'm not looking at him, he isn't going to move. Now, initially, I thought that this was a bug, but later on, it played in my favor, which you guys get to see in just a few moments. And, we'll just let that guy come over, all nice and gentle, as he wants to do it. Mm-hmm. So yeah, once this guy turns around, you are free to follow him and try to stick to the shadows on the left side of the wall there. You will probably be able to see a prominent spot because this guy does turn around mid-walk. And here I am trying to stick to the wall, which is the same button as the binoculars.
Get a look at those stiffs, Lambert?
Yeah. Did those uniforms look as Russian in person as they did on camera?
Can you think of any good reason for the Russian army to be here?
None that I like.
So yeah, I'm still not used to the controller. Sometimes the game doesn't work like it's supposed to. And right here, I try to pick the lock and then I suddenly realize that, you know what? Yeah, this isn't working out. I don't know how to pick a lock in this game. I'll just try it again when I'm more comfortable. Part of the reason behind it is also because of how, I haven't had a single checkpoint yet, and just clearing the first section is so difficult that I decided to, you know what, let's just play it safe. So right now, what you probably can hear that hear the guard not moving, and that's because I'm not looking at him. Basically, I guess the processor isn't registering him. I was having a certain trouble with this specific, bolt, I suppose. And then I started to finally get the hang of it. I realized, okay, I probably can do it under pressure. It was a pretty immersive experience, to be honest, having to pick locks like this as compared to the using just the keyboard and mouse. And this is the first checkpoint that we get. We just climb up this ladder, and unfortunately there is a searchlight up there. Now I'm actually playing this on the PC SX2, if you guys fail to hear that as well. And the thing is, if it was a PS2, I would probably have I could probably see the lighting and shadows better, but since this is a PC SX2, I can't really tell where the lights are coming from and where they're not coming from. So as a result, I'm having to just, I can't really tell whether the light is on me or not. So I just decided, you know what, let me just shoot this light out. And that's it, we just go up there and we keep waiting. We wait for these two guards to just quit their stuff, and when they're done, we can proceed along with our lives. As you can hear, the music has sort of died down, and let them, do that one more time. One of them did that, we need the other guy to do that as well. And once they're done, just stick to the wall and head over into the vent there. The problem is, unless and until they're doing this, it seems to be very difficult to get past these guys, at least for me. It may be easier for others, but now, remember when I said that it was this game wasn't properly designed this level? Here's one of those examples. Fisher has got a really difficult time getting inside this vent. In fact, I had to retry this level like 6 or 7 times just because Fisher did not want to get into the vents here for whatever reason. Now,
I guess nobody's gonna look for them in this big zone.
I gotta get back to my patrol.
Right, later.
So that's another one of the quirks of using the PC SX2, is that sometimes the audio skips. And it is what it is. It isn't a perfect emulator, but it is pretty damn good. I mean, it's running this game just fine. So, I mean, I don't have any complaints about that. And luckily in my run, I also got the sounds to all of the cutscenes. Sometimes when I ran the game, I couldn't get the sounds to the cutscenes, but luckily, whenever I finish Kalinatek, whenever I finish this level, I actually spent 2 days on this level, by the way, but whenever I finish this level, whenever I finish Kalinatek, I could actually get the sounds properly. And take the camera out, because the camera does tend to see you inevitably, and it also serves as a distraction of sorts. Now the problem is, this guy here isn't distracted. You want that guy near the camera when you distract him, and I accidentally run too fast because I'm not used to using the controller yet, and I alert this guy to my presence, and now he's investigating. Now I'm in a shit ton of trouble. So what I decide to do instead is I pull out my SC20 key and I decide to fire a distraction camera, hoping to distract both of these guards here. The problem is, both of them decide both of them decide that, you know what, we're not going to get distracted. Only I'm going to get distracted, the one that is walking over to the camera right now to investigate it. And here I am waiting for the other guy, as in, wait, what are you doing? When will you go investigate the camera? The answer is he won't. So, again, since I'm not really used to using the controller, I will be pulling my gun out here in just a moment. And since on the PC, you basically right-click if you want to use your attachment, but on the console, it's the left shoulder button, that is the L1 button. And so I basically press the wrong button. I press the fire button, which is the R1 button, the right shoulder button, and I just make it in time. Just make it in time.
Why would the Russians allow Nikoladze's people to use the plan?
We'll handle the politics, Fisher. Your mission's the antenna.
Oh yeah, by the way, I haven't apologized for it yet, but sorry for the crappy audio. I was actually streaming this game initially, and because I was streaming this game while you can see me being cautious right here, looking under every door before I open it, just because I don't want to retry all of that again. So yeah, I was initially streaming this game, and later on I realized that but the game was running super slow, so I was trying everything I could to make it faster, including, you know, compressing the sound quality. This is day one of the recording. This is me wondering whether this is where the box art for this for Splinter Cell came from. It is in this place, at any rate. So in this up until the next checkpoint, the first save point for this mission, that is, this sound quality is going to continue the next point onwards. As I was saying, the sound quality has already improved.
We had soldiers come to the plant in the 80s, escorting military scientists, I think. That was the 80s, and it was only a dozen soldiers. I haven't seen any scientists, but their paperwork is in order. It's strange. If our military needs the plant, fine. I don't argue with armed men.
I always loved this about the older Splinter Cell games, how witty they were in, you know, the dialogues. And there was a sense of humor in the dialogues, which is sadly missing from the latter trilogy. And I think I was deleting some of my previous recordings here, which I found out to be useless. And so here we are, just continue from underneath these grates. And don't worry about that guy noticing you, he won't for whatever reason it may be. Maybe because there's a lot of smoke here, or maybe because he can't see through the grates. But anyway, maybe he's noticing you. So once this guy has passed you, just not right now, just don't jump like I did, just stand up and walk right up to the edge of this thing, beware of the camera, and climb up, crawl under the camera, and you're clear to proceed up until these seal pipes here. Now, a professional or somebody who's much more practiced might be able to do what I'm about to do in just one shot, but I had a few difficulties on my own which I needed to consider. So this camera is looking, once this camera looks away, feel free to continue onwards. You can run a little faster here. I completely failed to notice that guy over there, and I was immediately like, oh shit. And I just scrambled back into the corner. Fortunately, this is cement, so you can practically, or rather asphalt, so you can be a little faster here. If you're using this nuke to hide, make sure that you aren't here in this place when this guy comes back from his patrol, because he can see you when you see you on his way back. He can't see you on his way from this place, but he can see you on his way back. And this was another one of my oh shit moments, because as soon as I turned the camera, I could see this guy there. Again, I tried to stick to the walls, but to no avail. And over here, I'm deciding where to go. I see the grate there, and I get really lucky here, because the camera was about to notice me, but it didn't. The guard wasn't looking in my direction either, and this is the third checkpoint. second, I think.
Hey, Esky, I was looking for you. You got rid of that flash RAM with the cooling rod access code, right?
Right, Lesnar. I'll do that straight away.
You got to. Anybody finds out I gave that to you, and I'm out of a job. Consider it done.
Happens. Sometimes, yeah, that's the second checkpoint. And you can see the alarm system in the bottom left corner, which is quite different from the PC version. Three alarms in there out, like, it's like you've got three lives. And I think Sam and Lambert make a joke about it in Chaos Theory, how three alarms doesn't mean you're dead. Now, why I'm sticking to this wall right here is because this technician, we need to grab this technician, and he usually goes to the left, but sometimes he has a tendency to come to the right for whatever reason it may be. So yeah, just grab him and take him over into the shadows. You don't really need to take him where I take him. Just take him where you're comfortable. Nice and easy, nice and cozy.
Hey, Esfer, who's looking for me? What the?
Stay quiet till you hear a question. I need to get into the cooling rod control.
I don't know.
Wait for the question. Ready? Here it is. What's the access code for the control?
560627.
Good. What's your connection to the military?
What? Don't hurt me. I don't understand.
This place is crawling with Russian soldiers. What are they doing here?
I don't know. This is Russia. Maybe they live here.
You're not very helpful.
Please don't hurt me.
So yeah, apparently when these guys, do their little knockout scream in this game, it can be heard by other guys, just like in Chaos Theory. So yeah, you might want to be careful about that. Right here, well, I was actually trying to, like you can see, I'm not used to the controller yet, and I was actually trying to, deploy this observation camera, right, a reconnaissance camera, but I accidentally fired yet again because of right mouse button and left shoulder button combination thing. So yeah, L1 RMB. Right here, you don't need to take this light out. I do, because it just helps me remain undetected by the camera, otherwise I would need to interrogate Esfer again. And man, look at that spread. Just look at that blood spread. I mean, at least they were honest about it in the PC version of the game. Right now, if as long as you're sticking to the right hand corner of this wall here, the camera will not see you. Be sure to make yourself slow when you approach underneath this camera, and you just need to time this section pretty well, because there are a lot of dynamics here. This guy will come towards you, the camera might see you, the camera is looking like it would be looking in the direction where you're headed, and there's another technician which comes out of this room there. So you just need to patiently sit here until everything falls into place. For me, luckily, this time around it was on the first try, it was very soon. For you guys, it might take a lot of time. So yeah, and this guy, he did not get alerted or suspicious or anything, but he sure did pull out his weapon because he saw the light missing there. So anyway, I took opportunity of this moment, and you just need to take a left, cut left, don't go forward, make sure that the camera in front of you isn't looking in your direction. And this here would be the third checkpoint of the level. There's another camera on the door to your right. We shall now try to take out this light bulb. Even though it hit the actual bulb, it's still going to take forever for this bulb to go out, for whatever reason it may be. And yeah, the same goes for the bulb in front of you. You don't need to take out this bulb, but you do need to take out this bulb, because otherwise the camera behind you will notice you, even if you're trying to take the camera out, that is. And it's really good at noticing you. The rest of the cameras in this game need to be looking at you to notice you, but that camera, the one over here, the one in question that we are going to be taking out next, That camera is a little difficult because it functions exactly like how... Just count how many bullets we sit right now, trying to take the slider, finally. And yeah, I was trying to put it back in, and yeah, I accidentally shot it off. So now you're in better darkness to take this camera out. And somehow cameras always, you know, get blown out with just one bullet. Lights, not really. The SC-20K is much more accurate in this game than the pistol, so I don't know what's up with that. Also, it doesn't really, you know, the SC-20K, unlike the PC version, it doesn't really alert other people around you when you fire it. So that's one thing. So anyway, those are the four control consoles that you need to deactivate. And you can run here, you can jump here, you can do whatever you want, because that other guy, he'll just stay down there. He's not gonna come over. There's a medkit there, you can pick it up. Not that you should need it, but yeah. So yeah, right now I'm just looking at the camera and trying to figure out how I can so in this instance the gun didn't even go off, and as soon as I climb up to this place, it turns out all of a sudden that there's more than one camera. So this is one of the things that I was talking about, how this level isn't specifically well designed. You've got a chemical clear here, which you can use if you want to, not that it'll be of much use. There's another camera right there which I tried taking out, and for the life of me I cannot. So yeah, it instead alerts this guy, which actually surprisingly makes this level much easier, this section much easier, probably much easier, and acts as a wonderful diversion. So yeah, I just let that guy come over, and I run back down, actually trying to hide right now for the time being. But yeah, I soon realized that, wait, that guy is abandoning his stations. And let me just take this camera out, and then I can head right over to the consoles and start messing with them one by one. And yeah, it's that easy. Unfortunately, Fisher can't jump and grab the ledge there. This level wasn't too particularly well made. There's another medkit here. Not that you should need it, but I just took it because I don't know whether I would need it or not, whether there would be a firefight at the end of the level or not. But there isn't, actually. So yeah, you're just supposed to go about and interact with all four consoles. And I would have interacted with the final console as well, had the guy not turned about and started coming towards me. I just stopped right there because I realized, wait, I can't see the guy. And yeah, I decided to start running. And the guy saw me, and that sort of pushed him towards me again to, you know, just investigate whatever it was that he saw over here. And he's still unaware of all the nuclear, you know, of the nuclear meltdown occurring in this power plant right now. And yeah, I don't know how it did not see me, but he turned over, and for whatever reason it was, he could not see me. So yeah, basically, I'm trying to find a good place to hide right now. So yeah, that door isn't open. The only door which is open is the one above you. And yeah, so right now you can literally just grab onto the fence there and save yourself a lot of time. which I will be doing in a while. The only place with enough shadows to hide in is this place right here on the ground, but unfortunately those guys, which you can see coming from up top, actually do search every single inch of this space right here. So the only thing left for you to do is climb onto this fence, and I'm glad that I tried it, because I actually had not anticipated this fence being climbable, but it was. So in the end, one of those guys will go back upstairs, and this guy, one of those guys will keep running in this area. So all you need to do is, when that guy goes away, the one guy who's still running, you just want to climb this and make sure that this guy isn't looking in your direction, because when he reaches down that middle part and towards the stairs, he will pause and he will look up at the stairs, trying to ascertain whether or not somebody has decided to climb them. And as soon as he turns back, just keep going. You don't need to be silent, you can run right here. I didn't know whether that other guy was waiting for me up top or not, so I decided to take it a little slow, because it has been a little bit of time since the last checkpoint. Yeah. Anyway, the camera is out now, you're all safe. I'm still taking it slow because I thought maybe the guy's still around, but he's not around. So yeah, as soon as you cross the store, it's safe point number 2.
Go ahead, Grim.
I took a look at the train yard in the lower spectrum. Somehow those barrels of nuclear waste are the only part of this plant not to emit radiation.
Needless to say, it's got our interest. Things on your offset.
That did not go as smoothly as planned, but yeah, that's a turret there.
Junior Wilkes says he's not going to be able to get within 30 kilometers of the plant. Keep your eyes peeled for local locomotion.
So yeah, that did not go as smoothly as planned. There's a guy down there that you want to want, and you want him to come upstairs. Yeah, I'll be panning the camera. Yeah, right there. So as soon as he comes upstairs and turns his back, make sure that you're walking softly and you're free to go. Yeah, I am still having difficulty with how much to move the controller with the analog stick so that I can move. Yeah, the problem with this place is it's pretty damn silent, and as soon as you make something, make a noise which is a little loud, it's gonna be problematic. What we want to do is we want to nab the technician that is on our right, and just fire a distraction camera, or you can just fire your gun. Doesn't really matter, both work the same way in this game. Firing the gun won't alert the others to your presence. You just want this guy to come in front of this console here, because there's like a well-lit area in the middle, and trying to grab him when he's there can be pretty difficult. Just pull him back into this cranny that we have between two pipes, and you're set to interrogate him, because the guard won't come all the way over here.
Not a sound. If you talk when I'm not asking, you're likely to come short. Understand?
Yes!
What's being loaded onto the train?
I don't know. Something heavy. Something dangerous.
Convince me you don't know.
I just monitor the dials. The contents are checked by network. But...
But what?
I think they might contain nuclear waste.
Why?
The way they treat it. I've seen one of the compartments empty. The walls were 10 centimeters thick at least.
Where is this train heading?
I don't know. China? India? We're further into Russia. The tracks branch.
You don't know much.
It's so true.
Why do they trust somebody who knows so little to do so important a job?
Higher security. The less people know, the less information can escape. That's
smart,
my
though.
No. I swear.
So here's the problem with this. Now, no matter where the guard is, if you choose to knock this guy out, the guard will come to know for whatever reason. And you don't really need to interrogate him, you can just, yeah, see? So, all you need to do is basically knock this guy out, and you just need his data stick. I just like to interrogate him nonetheless, for an added level of challenge. But, yeah. So yeah, if you decide to interrogate the technician instead of just knocking him out and getting you know, the data stick from his carcass. The vent you want to go to is up there, and this is where you, this is where the box art is from, the level which isn't featured on any of the levels, any of the games where the box art is. But yeah, this is where the box art is from, basically. One of the early prototypes of Sam, where he is still wearing his wetsuit mask.
Meaning they're shipping it somewhere that expected it to be watched.
We'll keep picking apart the logs. We need to find that relay.
So yeah, if you're interrogating that technician, you should make sure to also, you basically you need to knock out that guard.
No, I'll bet you a day's pay that it's radioactive.
Don't worry about these guys.
Of course it's radioactive. Everything in this country.
You've got plenty of time to lick them over. And this is another checkpoint right here. I think the fourth checkpoint in this mission thus far. Or maybe the third. I lost count. I think the fourth, yeah, the fourth. And yeah, there's a turret there which will not be able to notice you.
Despite the rest of the factory being on a state of alert, tap in and see what you can find.
So yeah, you can just practically go in through the glasses. There's nobody here. You can take your time. You can like literally rush ahead. And there's just this camera here that you want to be aware of. Make sure that you shoot it out. Or not. Your call, really. There's a medkit there. My medkit stock is full, so I can't really use it. And this here would be checkpoint number 5 of the game. So don't go out the door yet. Just keep looking, because there's a guy who's walking right beyond the shades, the blinds. And even though you can't see him, as soon as you open the door, he will be able to see you. So make sure that the guy is on his return patrol when you do decide to take the step outside of this room, and that he's well on his return patrol. So yeah, let him just turn over and start walking back. Yeah, now you're free to go. And just inch your way towards this door. Now, here's the thing. There are two guards inside this room, and one of these guards is walking near the window here, and he's got a shorter patrol path. The other guard has got a much longer patrol path, and he covers the outer perimeter of the outer arc of this room, this control center. So yeah, you can see the other guard in the background there, and if you actually take a look right now, you'll notice that the other guard is staring right at you, so you don't want to move. You want the guard, you want both the guards to be as near you as possible. In this case, the guard in the background will come over to the right hand corner, and this guard will come over to right in front of this door. As soon as this guard turns around, the other guard also starts walking off into his own patrol routine, and that is when you are free to move ahead and basically tail the guard on the right. Okay, you can actually hear both of them walking, and just make sure you're walking a little slow. There's no real need to rush, and yeah, I was being a little paranoid here. You can cross him as long as you're sticking to the right hand side of you know, the entire apparatus. You will not be seen, despite the fact that there's a huge glowy thing on the roof there. It will not be shedding light on you, so you're clear to proceed. I was just trying to play it a little safe, because I think I've retried this specific part 7 or 8 times as well, just because I didn't really know where or how somebody was, you know, noticing me. So anyway, moving on, just go ahead. And I actually missed my opportunity the first time around, but you can sort of wait here. So when the guy over there in the distance comes over and stands here, he'll have you backed, he'll have his back to you, and yeah, that is the time when you want to make your move for the door on your right. And yeah, once you open the door, it's pretty much the end of this section right here. I'll just let you guys see it. So you can make a move now, as I do. No need to rush, no need to be paranoid, no need to be cautious. Actually, a little bit of a need to be cautious.
What was all that noise out there? Fine, don't answer.
Christ, but this thing is complicated.
Stay quiet. You don't want your life to end in the boys' room. I want you to answer some questions.
Okay.
Why is the Russian military here?
They're assisting in the removal of waste. It's a government initiative.
That's what happens when you lie. Again, why are you here?
You're not really military. The uniforms are salvaged.
Who do you work for?
Georgians. Combine Nikoladze. I answer to a Russian. I don't want to say his name.
Vyacheslav Krinko.
I didn't tell you!
What do you need a nuclear power plant for?
At first, it was just another microwave relay. But now, we've started shipping things east. I don't know what we're shipping. Not many people do.
Where's it going?
I don't know. But the script on the receiving logs looks Chinese. I'm sorry I lied. Please don't hurt me!
So, Gringo couldn't...
Is that our signal, Grim?
I don't think... Wait! There! Jesus, that's clever! Masks using wavelength division multiplexing.
You don't say.
They were hiding their signal in the spaces between the Nadezhdas.
Then we got it. Back to you in a second, Fisher.
Lambert, I've got an extraction plan.
Go ahead.
I'll stow away on the disposal train. Tell Wilkes to meet me 35 kilometers down the tracks.
Will do. There's a door down the hall that will take you right there.
Alright, and this is save point 2 of this game. So, basically, this section...
Grimfangs got her trace on the relay. These files look like they'll clear the Russian government of any involvement. It's time you figure out a way to get out of there.
This is actually a pretty long level, and there's a guy to your right. If you can hear him moving, that means he's moving away. I tried ghosting this section for quite a number of times, and this is as far as I got. You could probably, you either need to take out the guy in front of you right now, or you need to set up a distraction. You can sit here and this guy will you know, just pass you smoothly without any problems or hesitations. But yeah, that's a problem. Right now, you either need a distraction if you choose to do this, choose to take my path, or...
Plant security says it's key code locked, but I think I can... Yeah, I just put the keypad code for the door on your off.
You need to knock him out unless you want to knock both of them out. So, yeah, that's basically a choice you have to make. And, yeah, that's pretty much it. So that's that, and I don't know why I picked the bodies up, I didn't need to, they're both in the shadows. But anyway, the thing is, yeah, as I was saying, Nikoladze couldn't really, you know, frame the Russians, and, you know, make them involved in a war, but he sure did, you know, take the, so he took the help of the Chinese. This is checkpoint number 6, I presume. But yeah, this is the last and final checkpoint. I love the way the controller vibrates in my hands when, you know, Sam's doing some of the other sort of activity, like sliding down this pole right here, working that pole. Anyway, so yeah, this section can be a little tricky. You want to make sure that the guy off in the distance, off in, you know, the right hand corner above the stairs, isn't looking at you when you're moving on these vents here. If you do it too early, he'll see you. If you do it too late, he will start shooting at you. He will get a better view of you. Right now what happened was, he saw me, but he couldn't see me completely, giving me the opportunity to hide behind the vents that I'm walking on and basically continue on my way. And this is what I was talking about earlier as well, when I said this game isn't well optimized. I could have used any of the chances that I got right now to basically just, you know, make a break for it. We just need to get onto the door at the on the right hand side. And I could have used all the opportunities that I have right now to do just that. Instead, I decided, you know what, let's just wait it out, let's not risk it, let's just see what happens. And yeah, so I waited until this guy came back upstairs, and, you know, like, resumed his normal patrol path after he convinced himself that there was nothing there. So as soon as that guy just goes on downstairs, you drop down and make sure he isn't looking at you. Yeah, you basically just let him walk past and just drop down. Make sure you're crouched. Walk gently over to the door, no need to run. And just open the door for extraction. And that is that for this level.
In Myanmar.
Nikoladze. We used the Kalinatek data to pinpoint him at the Chinese embassy in Rangoon.
Chinese support for the Georgian?
The political situation isn't good. If they are backing Nikoladze, you better find rock-solid proof. I don't want to go into World War III without a good reason.
You've got some time before you reach Rangoon. You want me to patch in a secure line so you can talk to Sarah?
No.
Nadezhda nuclear plant, Kola Peninsula, Russia, November 6th, 2004, 21:34 hours. Whereas the microwave relay system is destroyed in Nadezhda nuclear power plant, Nikoladze continues to launch information warfare attacks against the US from the Chinese embassy in Myanmar. Relations with the Chinese crumble over allegations of Chinese support for Nikoladze. The Chinese-Georgian connection must be investigated if war is to be averted. And, well, yeah, that was a nuclear power plant. I played it on the PCSX2, if I haven't mentioned it already. And honestly, I think I played the game for a total of, this level in specific, for a total of 3 or 3.5 hours. And, yeah, one of the things which baffled me the most was how this severe lack of, you know, quick saves in consoles. At least the PS2, I haven't tried any of the other consoles, to be honest. That is the only console I've ever had. I guess it belonged to a PC Master Race. Anyway, with the crappy PC, mind you. Here's the thing, though. Part of it, I don't know whether that was why I found this level to be a little difficult, or the fact that there were a few bugs at the starting of the level, or the fact that, you know, the level design was... well, a little made to be a little difficult, because when I played this level, it wasn't quite as difficult as Abattoir, but I mean, it was comparable to an extent. I mean, I personally found this level to be as difficult as Georgian Presidential Palace, and especially with the tight grouping of the guards and how difficult it is to time everything very correctly, especially if you're trying to cruise through this level. I tried, but I can't even recall how many times I've tried just to, you know, get caught. And every time I would get caught, since this is a console, I can't load up the previous checkpoint just like that. I would have to, you know, find another guard before the next checkpoint comes up so that I can actually get in front of them and, you know, just have them kill me so that I can restart the checkpoint again. But yeah, I mean, it was a pretty nice experience overall. I did enjoy playing on the console. I mean, I was using a Xbox controller for Windows for this, and yeah, it was quite challenging. I felt myself, you know, not having the same confidence as I do with the mouse and keyboard, simply because I'm not as used to the console. I don't want to get into firefights that easily, and on the PC I tend to pull risky maneuvers, and the quick saves again factor in there for that as well. They don't factor in into the console because there is an option for a quick save. You just get like 3 saves or 4 saves per mission, and there are like a few checkpoints if the developers are generous enough to provide you with them. And that's it. And there's nothing more that you can do about it. I don't know why, perhaps maybe because of memory limitations, especially in the PS2. But yeah, that's the thing. So, yeah, but on the bright side, retrying every single section that many times, it just sort of gives you a flow throughout the entire level, which I don't really know whether it's a good thing or a bad thing, but that's just basically what happens. Anyhow, I mean, I did actually enjoy playing this on the console, but given the difficulty of the first game, I am not really sure that I would want to continue playing it on the console beyond this level. I'll probably make a decision about that, but one of the things that I am looking forward to is playing Double Agent version 2 on the console, because, I mean, it is as smooth, as well designed as Chaos Theory is, and it seems to be quite well made. I mean, playing on the console was a completely different experience. And when I say console, I mean using a remote control, a controller. But yeah, I mean, playing on it was a completely different experience than versus playing it on the mouse and keyboard. And I actually pretty much liked the difference which it provided. Because previously, all I've played on the PS2 were, just generic, most of the time, fighting games. They didn't usually involve such sensitive motion as trying to make sure that, you move your joystick, the analog sticks a little, a little at a time, pretty sensitively, very cautiously. And yeah, I really haven't played shooters for the same reason either, because, I don't know how to aim for shit on the console. But it felt pretty good to play this level, and it was actually quite a masterfully done level. I mean, I played 5 missions to get to this point, and even though I might have taken some liberties in the missions before this, just because doesn't exactly matter. I'm trying to get to the nuclear power plant level. That is my main aim, to capture the mission. And one of the things that I did notice was how the level designs are simpler in the PS2. They've tried to make the game simpler by, altering the level designs and providing easier paths and providing lesser guards in every section. However, that being said, there are also quite a lot of I don't know why, but the simple level design just makes the game a little more complicated, and it actually makes the game a little more harder. Or maybe that was just because I'm not used to the controller, so that's probably one of the reasons why I find it to be a little harder than anticipated. But at any rate, I actually did enjoy playing the PS2 version of this game, and I would say that the entire journey to getting over to playing the nuclear power plant was pretty rewarding, if nothing else. And that's that. That would be that. And like I said, I'm making this video after I finish the game. Next video onwards, we'll be back to the PC version of the game. So yeah, kudos, enjoy it. Now go ahead and watch Chinese Embassy. This should hopefully provide more context into why we head over to Myanmar and what happened to the Russians and whatnot, especially if you're going to watch the bonus levels on my channel as well. So yeah, it does provide a lot of insight and a lot of closure to the entire storyline. This one level, when removed from the timeline, sort of creates this break in continuity, which causes a ton of confusion. And this level is pretty amazingly made. So if you guys want to watch this sort of prelude sort of thing to the next episode, then stick around, because you're gonna get some like news broadcasts and stuff after this, after I'm done talking right now. And that's it from me today. Until next time. Actually, that's it for me from me for an indefinite amount of time. I think I'll be playing... I mentioned in the final video in Selka Submarine that I would probably be playing something along the lines of Bulletstorm, but I think I've decided on what to play next. I will be playing Bright Memory before I go ahead and... or either that or Binary Domain before I go ahead and capture Daggerfall. And yeah, so that's it from me today. Stick around if you want to watch a few news broadcasts about the fallout of whatever happened during this one day that Fisher was in the Kola Peninsula in Russia before he heads over to Myanmar. And yeah, until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.
Has cleared Russia of any support for Kombain Nikoladze or involvement in the Georgian information crisis. Though tensions have eased on one front, the situation... The latest attack in Kombain Nikoladze's information crisis. 37 security and emergency services personnel have been declared dead with unknown casualties among employees at the dam. All non-essential personnel from the American Embassy in China were called back to the States earlier today in what analysts speculate could be preparation for Chinese hostilities. 2 days without updates as to health and well-being of the captured American soldiers, whose families today will be granted a personal audience with Vice President. Relations with China were already strained over disarmament negotiations. And the suspicion of involvement in the Georgian information crisis may very well push both sides.